Oh, it's September, and that is the time when the hibiscus is in season. So the hibiscus, also known as Roselle, this is a very tart, kind of fruity, you know, it's a fruit as far as I'm concerned. The leaves are very thick and juicy. And so that's what the seed looks like when you take the seed out. The seed is huge seeds for this plant. But this is what you make the tea from. And this has pectin in it. And some people will boil up the hibiscus with a seed and they make a jelly from it. But that's a ton of sugar. And who needs all that sugar? You can get the health benefits of hibiscus just by making a tea out of it. So I take the fresh flowers and you put them in your Instant Pot with filtered water. And I slice up the ginger and I'll put about that much in with about. So if you take that seed out, the flavor is a little bit better. And then you boil it. I do it for 30 minutes because I'm trying to extract all the good things. All of that goes into the water. Like red zinger type teas. That's what it's from. It's the petals of the Roselle flower. I prefer making my own dehydrated leaves because the stuff you get from the store is from Egypt or Turkey and it's not, I don't know how it was grown. I just like that there are local farmers who grow it and sell it so I can get it for them. For a farmer, it takes up a lot of earth and it's in the ground from March until September. You're not able to grow anything else. So. And it's not the cheapest herb, but it's very good for you. Legend that it helps reduce blood pressure. I don't know about that. Studies aren't very consistent with that. But I like to also just dehydrate it myself. Like these I peeled already. It's hard to, that seed is very sandpapery rough and it's a little hard to peel. So one tip is to dehydrate it for about 4 to 8 hours first at 125 degrees around there. Don't cook it at 180. It's just, I mean, if you're impatient, you want to, but if you dehydrate all the way with the seed on it, it'll get stuck to the seed, that the petals will dry right onto it and then it's impossible to pull off. And then you're stuck making tea with the dry seed, which it doesn't taste as good. So those are two ways, fresh with or without the seed, or dried, taking the seed out first or while you're drying.
So here's the hibiscus after you dry it yourself.
And then you have it for the spring when it gets hot again because the Roselle is only in season September, that's after the hot season, you want to dry it now and save it for making iced tea when the weather gets hot again. So I will just say it's really wonderful with ginger and it's really awesome. I mean, I put a ton of ginger in there, so it's spicy, it's tart, and it just feels like it's cleansing, which usually means that's code language for it's very strong and not for the faint of heart. But you don't have to make it that strong. You can always, if you make it strong, you can always dilute it later. So good stuff. Check it out. Roselle Hibiscus Ginger Tea.